Hello, I'm Paul Weston, and here is an interesting fact I discovered the other day. The total number of deaths from or with COVID-19 in England, amongst those aged under 60 and without one or more existing life-threatening illnesses, is pretty much zero, which paints a completely different picture to the tens of thousands of deaths propagated by our dishonest politicians and journalists. And before YouTube reaches for the Orwellian memory hole button, I'd like to point out I'm not just voicing an opinion, I'm simply relaying the actual statistics from the NHS England website here, which lists total deaths from COVID up to September the 10th, 2020. I'll link to this site below the video so you can look for yourself. Scroll down the page to the link outlined in yellow titled COVID-19 Total Announced Deaths 10th of September 2020 Weekly File and click on it. And this will open an Excel spreadsheet which looks like this, but when it's tidied up a bit, it looks like this. And as you can see, there are two columns for total deaths, one which lists those with pre-existing life-threatening illnesses in green, and the other in red, which lists COVID deaths without one or more pre-existing illnesses. And as you can see, the deaths under the age of 20 amount to 4, under the age of 40, at just 35, and under the age of 60, just 268, which added together gives you 307. And this number is so low, it's statistically irrelevant when it comes to changing the entire economic and social course of a country. But even this minuscule figure has to be taken with a pinch of salt, considering the scandal around the cause of deaths label in this country. Anyone who tested positive for COVID-19 in March and died in a car crash in July was considered by our wonderful and honest medical profession and brilliantly talented investigative journalists at the BBC to have died from COVID. And the Daily Telegraph first reported on this dishonest insanity on the 17th of July in an article titled Public Health England's Exaggerated Death Statistics Are a Scandal That Has Fed Fear. And the article went on to state, it appears that Public Health England compiles out-of-hospital deaths by searching the NHS database for whenever that person ever tested positive. It then apparently fails to consider how long ago that person tested positive or their actual cause of death. It is astonishing. Under these terms, a person who tested positive a few months ago but then gets hit by a bus this week would be recorded as a COVID death. In fact, if left unchanged, every single one of the 292,500 people who've tested positive will someday be a COVID-19 death statistic, even if they live for decades and die of completely unrelated causes. Health Secretary Matt Hancock has ordered an urgent review. End quote. Can you believe this? Health Secretary Hancock has ordered an urgent inquiry into something as ridiculous as a Defence Secretary ordering a urgent review into why soldiers mown down by an enemy machine gunner had their cause of death labelled as a touch of yellow fever rather than a high-velocity bullet. We have truly entered bizarro world here. And when this criminal dishonesty and stratospheric stupidity was put to Dr. Susan Hopkins, the Public Health England's incident director, she replied, "Although it may seem straightforward, there is no World Health Organization agreed method of counting deaths from COVID-19. In England, we count all those that have died who had a positive COVID-19 test at any point to ensure our data are as complete as possible." Well, it's certainly complete, Dr. Hopkins. It's complete and utter lunacy is what it is, not to mention completely dishonest propaganda. So it comes as no great surprise to discover that Dr. Susan Hopkins is involved in behavioural change at none other than Imperial College, home to the great thinker, truth-teller and mathematical visionary of the 21st century, Professor Niall Ferguson. And the fact that there was no designated cut-off point between testing positive at some point and dying from a skydiving accident in 2050, shamed the government into action, and they reduced the cut-off point to 28 days after testing positive. But the original scandal still exists. If you're buried under an avalanche on day 26, or flattened by a meteor on day 27, the government will still, today, label your death as COVID-19. So as insanity and dishonesty are still the order of the day, I would suggest that of the 307 who purportedly died from COVID, not a single one did. And why should they? COVID doesn't kill healthy people of any age. If it did, people would be keeling over left, right and centre, given the hundreds of thousands of people infected with coronavirus. Even if you're very old, it doesn't kill you unless you're also very ill. The average age of COVID death in England is 81, and the average number of pre-existing life-threatening illnesses also involved is close to 3. Now, most of those who died were male, so the COVID figures include men who were already 2 years over their average lifespan of 79 and who were also suffering several existing fatal illnesses. And you really couldn't make this sort of insanity up. And it's the same everywhere in the world. In America, the Centers for Disease Control, or CDC, admit that taking out the very old, who are also very ill, reduces the death toll by 94%, and in Italy by a whopping 99%. So I say again, no healthy person in England under the age of 60 has died from COVID-19, and only just over 1,000 have died aged over 60 without pre-existing life-threatening illnesses. Yet here we are, months after lockdown, shuffling round in masks that barely work to counter a threat that barely exists, because we were told, and are still told, that the great plague stalks the land and we're all doomed. Now, this is criminally dishonest, according to the stats from NHS England, and criminally dishonest according to the manner in which deaths are labelled by Public Health England. And what's so evil here, what's so dishonest, and what must surely be criminal, is the now known fact that tens of thousands of people really are dying because the NHS, clap for them, has effectively closed its doors to non-COVID patients, even whilst the hospitals remain empty and the staff idle. And when the whole COVID thing blew up in March this year, I predicted that unless there were gazillions of dead bodies littering the streets, the whole thing would blow over within weeks. Well, I was wrong about the whole thing blowing over, but that's only because this government, along with other governments around the world, have done the unthinkable and manufactured a massively exaggerated and false COVID death toll in order to keep us terrorised and compliant. Why are they doing this? Well, I mean, I've already hinted at the level of incompetence associated with our various governments is so off the scale, it has to be more than just well-intentioned stupidity, which is something I'll go into in my next video. In the meantime, please subscribe to my channel and activate the notification bell. I say this because my subscriber numbers drop daily, which I would like to think is a result of YouTube shenanigans rather than subscribers removing themselves voluntarily. And also, it's likely that YouTube will pull this video because British government statistics might well breach YouTube's community guidelines, make of that what you will. So please download it and mirror it at your own channels and websites. Thank you very much.